If I ask you, who is the author of the great epic Ramayana? Your answer would be sage Valmiki. Now, if I ask you, who wrote Mahabharata? For this, you would answer that Mahabharata was written by Maharishi Vyas. But did you know that it is only partially true? The reality is that Vyas is not the name of that sage, but the term Vyas is essentially a title like a king or a senapati. In the next few minutes, we are going to learn about the title of Vyas and the history of this concept.
Vyas, also known as Ved Vyas, is the title given to the Rishi who comes at the end of every Dwapar Yuga to segregate the knowledge of Ved into four and compile the Puranas and Mahabharata for the benefit of mankind in the degraded age that follows, which is the Kali Yuga. Vyas is a central and revered figure in most Hindu traditions. During every Dwapar Yuga of the Vaivasat Manvantar, different Vyasas have divided the Vedas 28 times. The names of some of the Vyasas of the past, as per the Puranas, are Lord Brahma, Prajapati Daksha, Shukracharya, Brihaspati, Surya, Vashishtha, Maharshi Bharadwaj, Rishi Gautam, Maharshi Valmiki, Sage Parashar, and Krishna Dvaipayana.
In the 28th Mahayuga, that is the current Yuga, Krishna Dvaipayana was Vedavyas, whose name refers to his complexion and birthplace, and who is believed to be a partial incarnation of Vishnu that occurs once in every Kalpa. In the upcoming 29th Mahayuga, Guru Drona's son, Rishi Ashwatthama, will be the next Vyasa. To know more about Yugas and Kalpa, check out our video on the Kala Chakra, where we have discussed this in detail.
Krishna Dvaipayan Vyas divided the Vedas into four parts and taught them to four of his disciples. He taught Paila, the Rig Veda, Vaishampayan, the Yajur Veda, Jayamani, the Sama Veda, Sumantu, the Atharva Veda, and Lomaharshana, the Puranas. Vyasa is considered one of the seven Chiranjeevis, long-lived or immortals, who are still in existence according to Hindu tradition. He was born on an island in the river Yamuna and was named Krishna Dvaipayan because of his dark complexion and birthplace. Vyasa had a son named Shuka, who was his spiritual successor and heir. As per Skanda Puran, Vyas married Vatika, also known as Pinjala, who was the daughter of a sage named Jabali. It is described that Vyasa's union with her produced his heir, who repeated everything that he heard, thus receiving the name Shuka. In some Puranic references, he is also referred to as a parent.
In the Mahabharata, Shantanu and Satyavati had two sons named Chitrangada and Vichitravirya. Both of them died early without leaving an heir. But Vichitravirya had two wives, Ambika and Ambalika. A widowed Satyavati initially asked her stepson Bhishma to marry both the queens, but he refused, citing his vow of celibacy. Satyavati then, forced by the circumstances, revealed her secret past and requested him to bring her firstborn to impregnate the widows under a tradition called Niyoga. By this time, Vyasa had compiled the Vedas.
As per the descriptions, sage Vyas was ugly with a dark complexion and matted hair. Hence, upon seeing him, Ambika, who was rather scared, and she shut her eyes, resulting in their child, Dhritarashtra, being born blind. The other queen, Ambalika, turned pale upon meeting Vyasa, which resulted in their child, Pandu, being born pale. Alarmed, Satyavati requested that Vyas meet Ambika again and grant her another son. Ambika instead sent her maid to meet Rishi Vyasa. The duty-bound maid was calm and composed. She had a healthy child who was later named Vidur.
Vyas is traditionally known as the chronicler of this epic and also features as an important character in Mahabharata. Vyas asks Ganesha to assist him in writing the text. Ganesha imposes a precondition that he would do so only if Vyas would narrate the story without a pause. Vyas set a counter condition that Ganesha understands the verses first before transcribing them. Thus, Vyas narrated the entire Mahabharata and all the Upanishads and the 18 Puranas while Lord Ganesh wrote. Vyasa's Jaya, which literally means victory, is the core of the Mahabharata, is a dialogue between Dhritarashtra and Sanjaya. Dhritarashtra is the Kuru king and the father of the Kauravas, who opposed the Pandavas in Kurukshetra war, and Sanjay was his advisor and charioteer. Sanjay narrates the particulars of the Kurukshetra war fought in 18 days chronologically. Dhritarashtra at the time asks questions and expresses doubts, sometimes lamenting, fearing the destruction the war would bring on his family, friends and kin. This text, known as Jaya, is the original composition of Maharishi Krishna Dwaipayana Vyas, and it contains only 8,000 verses. Jaya underwent multiple additions over a period of centuries, and then it came to be known as Bharat, which had 24,000 verses. However, the current version called Mahabharat consists of 100,000 verses, and that is a much later composition. We are going to make a separate video on the topic of dating the Mahabharat war based on astronomical and archaeological references.
The final version of Vyasa's work, namely the Mahabharat, is structured as a narration by Ugrasrava Sauti, a professional storyteller, to an assembly of rishis who in the forest of Naimisha had just attended the 12-year sacrifice known as Saunaka, also known as Kulapati. Vyas is also credited with the writing of the 18 major Puranas, which are works of Indian literature that cover an encyclopedic range of topics covering various scriptures. The Yoga Bhashya, a commentary on the Yoga Sutras of Patanjali, is attributed to Vyasa. In Brahma Avatar, one of the compositions in Dasam Grantha, the second scripture of the Sikhs, Guru Gobind Singh mentions Rishi Vyas as an avatar of Brahma. He is considered the fifth incarnation of Brahma. Guru Gobind Singh wrote a brief account of Rishi Vyasa's compositions about great kings Manu, Prithu, Bharat, Jujat, Pain, Mundata, Dilip, Raghuraj and Aj, and attributed him to the store of Vedic learning. Vyas is widely revered in Hindu traditions. A grand temple in honor of Sri Vedavyas has been built in Orai, Uttar Pradesh. The temple is known as Sri Bal Vyas Mandir.
So why are we sharing this information today? Because today is Guru Purnima. The festival of Guru Purnima is dedicated to Vyas. It is also known as Vyasa Purnima, the day believed to be both of his birth and when he divided the Vedas. This is the reason why we are making this video today on the occasion of Guru Purnima. Hinduism has a wonderful idea that Guru is considered to be greater than God. Guru is the one who doesn't just educate you, but he enlightens you. A Guru is a person who makes you a human. As per Smritis, every individual who gains knowledge is a Dvija, which means twice born. A person is born biologically, the first time from his mother, and a person is born the second time intellectually from his Guru. Thus, a Guru is equally respected as a mother in Hindu beliefs. The example of Krishna Dwaipayana teaches us that a Guru can be anyone, irrespective of their caste, color, sex and religion. Let us celebrate this day as Guru Purnima, remembering Maharishi Vyas. Stay tuned, stay educated, and last but not the least, know your culture by self-investigating the truth. Shubhaste Panthanas Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.